Well, one of the cars that the competitors will be racing in is the Peugeot 905 Evo from 1993. But Yannick Dalmas won in a 905 in 1992 at Le Mans. Yannick, the 93 Evo was a real turning point for Peugeot, for sports car racing, and really made its mark in history, didn't it?
Yes, Louise, for me it was in the period in my life in motor racing. It was fantastic. And the Evo, we had sequential gearbox, you know. The year before we have the H gearbox. It's a big difference. The engine was a little bit stronger, the rev stronger, the general evolution in the car was fantastic. Also, one thing very, very important and never forget, a Michelin make it a really good job for our car also. We came today, depends the period, you know, during the race, sometimes double stints, sometimes during the night, three stints with the tires. But at this time, we make it double stints easily. The car was really fast, really, really fast and straight. Not very easy to drive, but the racing car never easy to drive, but comfortable. The sensation, the handling of the car on a fast car, you know, Le Mans. Between, you know, the Porsche curve until the finish line, this part of the circuit is very difficult, very fast. You need a strong car, this part. And the car was not easy to drive, but very, very efficient. You have to be concentrated 100% all the time. Until on a long straight, concentrate between the braking, because the car also was very, very efficient on the braking. And you need to be very strong during your stints. Difficult to lose your concentration 1 second because it was really nice, yeah.
The team worked very hard between 92 and 93 to make all those changes and to really develop the car, didn't they?
Yes. We make it, I think, between a 3 and nearly 5 24-hour simulation.
Wow.
Why? To prepare everything, to be honest, it was a lot of work. At this period, it was different because we stay many hours in the car. For me, when I jump in the car, it's like sitting in your seat in front of the TV, you know. It was exactly the same because we developed a lot of things, braking, the brakes, the aerodynamic, the engines, the tires also.
And it looked amazing as well.
Yes.
It really did.
The team was more stronger in 93 than 92. In 92, it was the World Championship, Le Mans. And the World Championship continue. And the team Peugeot make it incredible work, you know. And I was, of course, it was my 3rd years with Peugeot. Everything, you know, the management from Jean Todt, the engineers, the logistic, everything was for the perfection. During the race, we had a small problem, I think, our car was a transponder or something like that. But the position, it was Peugeot, was 1, 2, 3.
Yeah. How, when does that happen?
Yes, we make it really. My co-driver was Thierry Boutsen.
Right.
And we had just this small problem, you know. But about the result, after I don't know, it's a long time ago, but when the position from Peugeot was 1, 2, 3, Jean Todt decided to fix the position. And I wasn't at this time a factory driver, you know. The year before we won the World Championship, we won Le Mans. I think for the drivers, to be honest, it's difficult to accept 5 hours before the end to fix the position, but definitely it was difficult, but you have to respect the decision from the management. You work for the factory, you don't work for yourself. It's important to understand.
It's the team.
It's a team. And when you have the chance to be around the factory Peugeot, the people worked day and night for the good result.
So you know that you're all working towards the same thing.
Together. You lose or you win together.
Never alone.
Never alone.
Yeah.
And for me, of course, I was a little bit frustrated, but to be honest, the global result, I was happy.
Of course.
Because Jean Todt, you know, he gave you the chance to be part as a team. To make
history.
A good job, a good result, a good working with the engineer, I repeat, but around the people. And for me, it was important.